the pandemic has thrown into sharp focus the struggles our elderly population faces on a daily basis. But one company in California is trying to help us understand those challenges by using virtual reality.
Hi, Beatrice. We've been feeling less like ourselves lately.
I am embodying Beatrice Rogers, a woman in her mid-60s living with Alzheimer's disease.
Hi, Beatrice. Do you remember me? I'm Nurse Gabby.
She is afraid.
Intruder!
She's disoriented.
Tell them to leave!
And her loved ones are frustrated too. And while she finds it difficult to communicate, Beatrice still finds a sense of joy in the music that brings back memories.
I experienced being Beatrice, and I felt her anxiety, I felt her confusion, and I also felt her shame, for lack of a better word. My reaction really surprised me. I wasn't expecting that from a VR headset.
Even though she was someone living with Alzheimer's, it didn't mean she was any less of a person who could still feel and sense just, you know, how she was being treated by others.
I'm speaking with Carrie Shaw, the founder and CEO of Embodied Labs, a Los Angeles-based immersive training platform that employs VR to help healthcare workers step into the shoes of their patients. The Beatrice Lab that I experienced is personal to Shaw, who herself became a caregiver at the age of 19 when her mother, Becky, received a diagnosis of early onset Alzheimer's.
I definitely wouldn't have guessed that it would culminate in founding this company.
Beatrice is right for your medicine.
Through the company's software, users can peer into the life of an elderly person for 5 to 8 minutes as the character experiences the illnesses and indignities that come with aging.
Dad, I can't see or hear you. Can you see or hear me?
I'm here, but I don't know why you can't see me.
Dad, is your camera or your speaker on?
It could be Frank, a man faced with social isolation and loneliness.
Hi.
Or Eden, a 72-year-old transgender woman who is connecting with other older adults in the LGBT community.
Technology has really pushed the boundaries of how we can visualize and understand human health.
Why is virtual reality an effective medium to train caregivers?
We're tricking our brains into perceiving that this is a real and lived experience. When we put on a VR headset, our minds become shaped by what we're seeing and doing in the headset.
It becomes a memory that you gained in a virtual world, but you can absolutely apply in the real world.
Exactly. That memory is oftentimes tied to emotion. It's one of the things that is also really special about an immersive training environment.
With a name to help caregivers become more effective at their jobs, Embodied Labs partnered with retirement communities like California-based Front Porch.
I knew that we needed new ways to train our workforce that would be engaging and impactful, and this really struck me from the beginning as something that would exactly do that.
Today, Tanya Mazzolini, a manager of a Front Porch facility in Pasadena, is trying out the Frank Lab, developed as a response to increased isolation faced by seniors during the pandemic.
That was so sad. Oh, wow. You feel so bad for him.
Why haven't you returned my calls?
Dad, I don't think this is real.
I've never experienced anything that can put me in the shoes of one of my residents and know what they're feeling.
Do you think your technology will help normalize conversations about elder care, mortality, and aging?
We're all aging, and we statistically are going to experience some kind of change as we grow older that's going to impact the way that we interact with humans around us, and it just made me think about, you know, the world I want to age into.
With her team, Shaw develops the various learning modules with the consultation of medical experts and the family members of people experiencing aging issues. Shaw says the team strives to create an interactive experience that is rooted in scientific accuracy.
From my perspective, as a director and working with these actors and helping them embody these characters, getting to understand some of the medical conditions that the characters are in and think about how they relate through the world was really new for me.
Other companies like Chicago-based LevelX are also using technology to train medical professionals.
We have games where you're doing full realistic 3D surgery, where you're cutting and cauterizing, and there's bleeds and fluids and soft tissues, and it's all being simulated at 30 to 60 frames per second on your phone, you know, that thing that drops your calls all the time.
The company makes smartphone games for doctors that simulate procedures like colonoscopies or administering anesthesia.
This is an opportunity to help develop the skills of medical professionals. You can pick up your phone and play through dozens of rare, challenging cases that, you know, other colleagues around the world may have encountered.
Through immersive technology, Shaw says she is hopeful that healthcare can be transformed for the better.
It takes, you know, as few as 5 minutes to go through a module that can give you insight that might change your whole life, you personally. It might help you make a healthier decision for yourself or pick up the phone and call your grandma.